You want to know what's so frustrating about security? No matter what I say here on this channel, no matter how careful I am with my own passwords, and no matter what software or strategy I use, there's always a but. I create strong passwords.
But what if a keylogger gets installed on your computer?
Okay, well, I write down my passwords.
But what if you lose that book or it gets burned in a fire?
I use a password manager.
Okay, now wait, Josh, what if those password managers get hacked?
It's like playing a game that you can never win. But instead of getting frustrated or confused by all the new technology available, let me share with you the three levels of password security, two of which are quite common, and the third of which, quite frankly, is just insane. You need to choose which level you feel most comfortable with, and I'll give you some tips to make sure you can minimize your risk at each one of these levels. Welcome to All Things Secured. My name's Josh, and I'm gonna start by saying that if you're just using the same password for all your online logins, I'm not even counting that as a level of security. Nowadays, that's simply irresponsible. If that's you, listen carefully to what I'm about to say and choose which direction that you wanna go. The first level is the most low tech, but it's not an altogether bad method, manually writing your passwords down. This is what my parents like to do. You can either keep a password journal or a document on your device that you reference when you need to log in. The obvious advantage with a password journal is that it's usually not uploaded to the internet. But that also means that you have to have that journal or that document physically with you anytime that you need to log in. This first level of password security is great for those who know how to create strong passwords already. And for the sake of your loved ones, make sure you have some sort of backup of this password journal or document in case it gets stolen, lost, or burned in a fire. And here are two quick tips for those who feel comfortable at this first level of password security. First, don't just use a scrap piece of paper that you keep near your desk. Invest a few dollars in a nice password journal on Amazon. They're really cheap. I've got a few links in the description below. And start using something that will remind you of how valuable these passwords really are. Second, if you want a bit of extra security, don't write down your actual passwords in the notebook or document. Instead, write out something that has meaning to you and helps you remember the password but makes no sense to anybody else. So for example, if your password is your favorite NBA team followed by the street number for your first house you lived in, instead of writing down Bulls.2508, you could write down MJ.house. As long as you can remember that MJ stands for Michael Jordan, who played on the Bulls, and house reminds you of that particular number, the code could work. Now, let me play devil's advocate here for a moment. Sure, you've added a little bit of security to your password journal, but this only works if you can actually remember the code and someone in your family can decipher it as well. Otherwise, your online accounts just die when you do. Of course, you could jump down to the next level of password security, level 2, which is the password manager. Sometimes the greatest advantage of a password manager is that it usually helps you to create stronger passwords by suggesting random passwords that you would have never thought of on your own. I categorize password managers into two camps. You've got the offline and the online. Offline apps like KeePass and PasswordSafe are usually free, but they don't upload your vault to the cloud. In other words, you can't sync your password vault between devices and there's no backup stored anywhere on the internet. Now, some would argue that this offline method is better for security since your password vault isn't traveling through the internet. But I could also counter by saying that you still need to have a backup of your offline vault to minimize the risk if you lose your device, right? And your security is only as strong as how securely you store that backup, right? And on and on and on we go into deeper levels of paranoia. Online password managers like 1Password, which is what I use, they offer a slightly better user experience, but they do cost a bit of money. These companies store your vault online so that you can sync your password between all of your devices and always have a backup in case you lose that device.
But wait, what if those password managers get hacked?
Well, that's highly unlikely. And there are security measures that still require my master password before the hacked vault is even usable.
What if your master password gets leaked? Or what if these companies are lying about their encryption or their privacy policies?
Gee whiz, do you have trust issues or what? Okay, if you feel comfortable at this password manager level of password security, but you still feel a little bit skeptical about trusting one company with all of your passwords, here's what I suggest. I use a strategy called a double blind password, where the password I store for my most valuable logins, that's stuff like my bank, my email, and my investments, they aren't the real password. Try to follow along with me here. I allow my password manager app to create the first 12 to 15 unique characters of each password, and then I always add the last 4 to 5 digits manually each time I log in. With this method, my password manager doesn't know my full password, but then again, neither do I. It's a double blind password. This protects me against keyloggers or that crazy scenario where my password vault somehow gets hacked, which honestly, I've never heard of happening anyway. All right, I'm gonna go into more detail, or I already have gone into more detail about how to set up a double blind password in this video that I suggest you watch here. Here's the bottom line. Whether or not you use the double blind password manager, a password manager, it's an excellent way to create and store strong passwords. And despite any perceived risks, I can easily recommend this as a secure option. Like I said earlier, I use 1Password and I have an affiliate link in the description if you want to give it a try for free. Before we go deeper into this black hole that is your online security risk management, go ahead and click that like button and the subscribe button. These are the kind of videos that are going to really help you increase your privacy and security. And there's a lot more great content that you don't want to miss. Okay. So there are probably a number of different directions I could head with this third level of password security, but no matter how you slice it, we're moving into territory of absolute paranoia, pretty much close to insanity. This last month, I've been working with a new tool known as OnlyKey. The best way that I can describe this is really a cross between a physical password manager and two-factor authentication key. This little device that I can carry with me on my keychain will hold up to 24 login password combinations that aren't stored in the cloud, and it's not on my computer either. It's only stored here and protected by a 7 to 10 digit number combination that I can set. Now I have to plug this key into my USB port, type in the correct password, and then press the number that corresponds to the appropriate login. So if I set Twitter as preset number 3 here, which I've done, the key automatically logs into Twitter by typing in the username and password that I've previously set on here. If somebody tries to hack the PIN code, the key auto-deletes itself after 10 failed attempts. Oh yeah, and I can also set a dead man's code that wipes the whole key clean if somebody forces me to open it for them. Super paranoid, right? Well, it's a novel approach to password security, I admit, but the setup process was a bit technical, so it's not something I would recommend unless you consider yourself tech savvy. I've put an affiliate link to the OnlyKey in the description if you're interested to learn more. So which level of password security do you prefer and why? Leave a comment below to explain a bit of your strategy so we can all learn together.